Come on. It's the replay. Doing it again. Because we found out that the sound was out. Soon as you see it, share it with as many people as you can. Monday's meal, manna, to move you towards your life mandate. We know that Jesus will. I apologize for the first stream, but we're going to do it again. Forgive us on the technical difficulties. It is still that Jesus will. Share this with as many as you can. Soon as you see it. Got to do it manually tonight. Computers crashing, stuff going crazy. That's why I know it's a word from the Lord. Come on, share this. So soon as you see it, grab as many as you can. The replay of Monday's meal. Still, in our world, we know that Jesus will. When I would do wrong, we know Jesus will. Thank you for tuning in tonight. Listen, I apologize for the sound not being in. If you could see my Mac right now, but that's a whole nother story. I'm Dr. Ray Johnson, senior pastor at Dominion Outreach Worship Center. This is the replay of Monday's Meal, manna to move you towards your life mandate. As I mentioned, it is the month of October, the month of 10. It's where the number 10 means judgment, to where one thing ends and a new thing begins. And you've made it all the way to this point in the year so that old thing can end and a new thing can begin. And tonight we're going to spend some time with some nuggets of truth talking about the why to a new venture, a new idea, a new concept, a new branding tool, or a new opportunity to enter into the marketplace. Have you ever thought about why enter into it? You know, we started this new series called Occupy in the Walk of Dominion. And in this new series, what we came to understand is that everything that Jesus did, he did on purpose with a why. And I'm giving away the first one already early tonight, just to make up for the time that is already transpired and transpired. So listen, if you have not had a chance to share this, do it real quickly. Share it. Let's get as many people in as you can. Don't want you to miss this word of truth on tonight that will help move you toward your life mandate. So let's get right on into it. We've been looking at, we begin the series of occupying, taking up space, with the understanding that Jesus went on purpose to the demoniac of Gadara, because that area called Gadara or the Gadarenes literally meant reward. And there was one man who was keeping people from receiving their reward. And because he had all of these unclean spirits, Jesus went into this place on purpose to remove those spirits in order not only just to set the man free, but to model to his disciples about why he does what he was doing, and to also change the system that contributed to this man being into this kind of a bondage. It was a port city. If you just go back just a few, one chapter before, in chapter 4 and verse 34 and 35, what you'll find is that there's a shortage of food, and the disciples come to Jesus and they say to him, Master, these people, send them away, they're hungry. He says, no, you give them something to eat. All that was in the crowd was a small lunch from a little boy, 2 fish and 5 loaves. Did you hear what I said? It was a port city. With it being a port city, living in this culture where people make their living by fishing, only 2 fish and 5 pieces of bread, and Jesus had to expand that with a miracle. So he went to this area and the Gadarenes to deliver this one man so that everybody else could be free. Question tonight is, Why are you going into the marketplace? Why your new branding tool? Why your new business venture? Why are you attempting to engage the way that you are engaging? Who's going to be free because you've entered in to this new idea, this new concept, this new venture, this new ministry, this new marketplace, this new understanding? What's going to be the end result of that? Have you taken time to think about that before you venture into it? Come on, number two, quickly. Because the other thing that Jesus did was he had a plan. And many people enter into the new thing that God gives them without a plan. They enter into it without objectives, without goals, without tactics, without strategies, without an evaluation process. How do you know if you're successful or not? How do you know you're actually meeting your price points for business people? How do you know you're actually impacting lives for ministry people? How do you know that you're actually reaching more people and connecting more people into the process for marketing people? How do you actually know? You need a plan. You need a strategy. You actually need tactics and steps that are going to build into what it is that you're looking to see to get done. He had a plan. Let me go back to Mark 4 and 35. He said to his disciples, he didn't even give them a chance to be excited about the new opportunity that they were engaged in terms of the 12 baskets full. Now, he fed close to 5 to 30,000 something people. After that miracle was over, the disciples, they got the leftovers and even they got full. Man, I don't got time to preach tonight, but God can keep you and he can fill your life and meet the ministry need or meet the idea or meet the new business venture need for you with just the leftovers. But that's a whole nother moment right there. Don't even got that much time to go into that. So what he does is he doesn't even give them a chance to celebrate with it too much. He says, come on, let's go to the other side. As he takes them to the other side, he does so with a plan. What's the plan, you say, preacher? He moves with the inside of a boat. That's a plan. That's a means of moving from point A to point B. Have you figured out what your plan is that's going to move you from point A to point B in this new venture, this new idea, this new concept, this new strategy? Have you figured out how you're going to get from one place to the next as you occupy and do business until he comes? If you haven't figured that out yet, you may want to slow your roll and not move into it, because so many people, they start with zeal and they start with vigor and they start with such focus, but without the plan, the vision that they have, they may even have their why, but the vision that they have doesn't come to fruition without the plan. And finally, I'm landing the plane tonight. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for sharing. This is the replay of Monday's meal about why begin the new idea, why begin the new venture. And Jesus is our model. He models to his disciples about why he's doing what he's doing. He's changing the system. He's delivering the person from bondage. And he is also showing how to do what you need to get done. So that's his why. His plan, or I should say his purpose. His plan is he takes a boat and moves from one side to the other. And finally, one of the reasons why you do it is because promises get fulfilled on the inside of it. My God, I hope that is helpful for somebody tonight. Here is the promise. Jesus has the man delivered and set free, sitting beside him, clothed in his right mind. Let me say that again. That's the promise being fulfilled. What's going to be the end result of what it is that you start, what it is that you expand, what it is that you begin again in, what it is that you try new, what promise is going to be fulfilled as a result of doing it? Have the end in mind before you begin. I hope this has been helpful tonight. It's Monday's meal, nuggets to help move you in your life mandate. And listen, want to make sure you wake up in the morning with Lady, that's right, with Tilt Tuesday. She's got more nuggets to share and more things that will help you bring your stuff to the life mandate that God's called you to. Thank you all for tuning in and hanging in with me. We promise next week to make sure that things are a little bit more fluid. Take care. Share this with a friend. God bless. Bye-bye.